Hello everyone, this is David. Today I'm going to do a little beginning tutorial for panel lining your Gunpla. This isn't going to go into any complex methodology, just some simple stuff. Today I will be doing a little panel lining on my HG Build Burning Gundam. You can find the review of that on our channel here. Now, just going to do the leg here just to show how I do this, and today I'm going to be using just a standard Gundam marker. Now when I was in the States, what I would prefer to do is I would use the ultra fine tip Sharpie. They work actually really well. I kind of prefer them to the Gundam markers, but they're hard to find here, and Gundam markers are really, really cheap here, so they work pretty well. Now the other thing, tissue. Just standard old tissue. I wouldn't use this on a fresh paint job, but with little HG kits like this, particularly ones that haven't been painted, that I'm just doing a little basic panel lining on, works fine. Now, with the Gundam marker, what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to find the panels that you want to fuss with. In this case, I'm going to take off this little piece right here because I am going to give it a little bit of accent. And then I'm going to go over this sort of Y shape here. That's going to be what I'm going to accent today. Now, the great thing about panel lining with a Gundam marker, you do not have to be precise at all. This is not complicated. This is not tracing. So what you're going to want to do is just go over the area that you want to panel line. And just want to thoroughly give it a nice amount of ink. Okay, now you see that's really rough, that's really raw. And if you rub it away though, it ceases to be. I'm using my finger. Can also just use that. And you just rub it. Since you are going into a little valley of plastic, your tissue is not going to get in there. It's just going to get whatever is outside the lines. Now, as you can see, that looks a lot tighter. With this panel here, I'm just going to edge around it. And again, not too important if I screw up a little bit, because I am going to wipe off the excess. Okay. This is going to be a much subtler accent, because we aren't going to be showing off the edges here. Okay. I'm going to snap that on. Now you can only see a little faint bit on the edges there. That's actually intentional. And you can repeat this process pretty easily with anything that has an edge on the Gunpla. And you might want to give it a pretty firm rub too. Don't be afraid to do it twice if you accidentally do get into the crevice. That's not going to hurt anything. Now another thing that you can do, I usually use the gray Gundam markers for this because it tends to look a little better. But if you are doing something that is an outcropping, like this is not a valley, this is just a line that I'm going to try to accent. I'm going to use the edge of the Gundam marker rather than the tip. And I'm just going to I'm going to hold this thing stable as I can on camera. And I'm just going to lightly, barely touch the edge there. Now I have a line. There you go. And now you have a nice little accent line. And do it on this ankle piece. Okay. Now that gives it an almost cartoony look. That's very much if you want to sort of emulate the look of a manga, give it those extra accents. I don't particularly like those in on most kits unless I want it to look sort of toyish. But if you are gentle with it, you can rub away just a touch or just a little hint. And what that does is that gives you a shaded effect on that edge. Yeah, it's just a subtly shaded effect. But there you go. That's real simple panel lining with a Gundam marker. And I hope you found that informative. If you like our videos that we've been doing, please like, comment, and subscribe. If you would like to request a specific Gunpla review, or if you would like to, if you would like a specific technique of Gunpla building to be covered, I will do that. Just drop it in the comments. I will be taking requests. All right, everyone, have a great day.